Purdue University food scientist Professor Philip Nelson crowned a stellar five-decade career with the 2007 World Food Prize, the Nobel Prize in his field. Nelson was recognized for his research that led to aseptic food processing and transportation. The sterile technology prevents liquid-based produce such as orange juice and tomato paste from spoiling for months on end, even without refrigeration. His research is credited with bringing tasty, healthy food to millions of people around the world, often in places where geography, climate, or poverty might otherwise have stood in the way. But Nelson says his breakthroughs never would have reached market without early and frequent support from private industry. When Nelson began his research in the 1960s, it was uncommon for private industry to partner with university researchers. But in 1968, unable to obtain government or university support for his food preservation ideas, Nelson sent unsolicited letters to 10 companies.
I was told at the time when I decided to get some industry funding that it probably wouldn't help my career. At that time in the history of the land-grant universities, it wasn't appropriate really to take industry money of the significance that I had. So I sort of feel like a Neil Armstrong in my own right, in that I broke some new ground, I think, at that time.
Only one company, a family-owned business in Ohio that supplied tanks to brewers, responded to that first letter. Its purchase of patents helped fund Nelson's research. Nelson then convinced several food corporations, including Hunt's, Heinz, and Campbell's, to visit Purdue, but they initially spurned his 100 and 1,000-gallon tanks as much too small for their industrial purposes. So Nelson found a smaller Indiana-based company, Noss Foods, that was willing to grow together with Nelson's team. Success with Noss prompted Nelson to explore the possibility of mobile aseptic tanks.
Well, Hunt Wesson got excited about this and built about 150 of the rail cars, aseptic rail cars, 20,000 gallons each, to move tomato paste from the West Coast to the East Coast. Rather than shipping the bottles and the containers, they would make their ketchup and sauces nearer the population.
Nelson next experimented with storing orange juice in aseptic tanks, but after a few weeks, the juice developed off flavors.
But a company called Tropicana says, I think we can make this work, and we'd like to have your technology. And they had a four-year exclusive. And they simply just put in some small tanks, 1.2 million gallon tanks. Those tanks, to get perspective, is six stories tall and six stories across. I mean, they are huge.
Several brands, including Tropicana, now bring their juice to market aseptically in milk carton-like containers. The key to maintaining fresh taste was to slightly refrigerate the juice to 40 degrees while still stored in the big tanks.
So now all of these tanks are put in warehouses like this. And I just, I suppose there's probably 300 in Florida now, getting bigger and bigger. It's scary, but it's working. And the neat thing is they can pull product out the year round. We get orange juice, as you know, year round. And at that point they can add, you know, whatever, pulp, no pulp, vitamins, nutrients, everything that you can think of that a consumer might want, you'll find it in orange juice today.
Seeing that his nation was losing market share, the head of the Brazilian citrus industry asked Nelson to help bring Brazilian juices to overseas markets, including the United States. Nelson worked with a Norwegian shipbuilder to create a tanker that held 3.2 million gallons of orange juice.
Well, it didn't stop there. They have two of these ships now, 8 million gallons of single-strength orange juice. There are 16 tanks inside the hull of the ship. This is the length of three football fields. It's incredible to think, you know, what can happen when you put industry and university together.
Nelson proceeded to develop a smaller, lighter container known as bag-in-a-box, a flexible system that brings an array of food products closer to market in containers typically no larger than 300 gallons. For 25 years, Nelson has trained industry leaders from around the world in these aseptic technologies at an annual workshop at Purdue, as well as at individual companies by arrangement.
The largest aseptic plant in the world has been built near Anderson, Indiana, the Nestle Company. And in their discussions, they said one of the reasons, obviously the state gave them benefits, but one of the reasons they located in Indiana was because of Purdue University. And we've already had a workshop, one workshop for Nestle.
Purdue researchers are now exploring how to ensure that fresh produce, such as spinach, can dependably reach market clean and free of pathogens such as E. coli.
We're now up to a pilot scale where we're trying to see if it can be made to work commercially. And we have a lot of young scientists in our Department of Food Science working in this area. So it's an exciting time.
Nelson hopes to bring this new technology to market within 2 years. He says that such breakthroughs are much more quickly adapted when university researchers, such as himself, are able to partner with private industry. At Purdue University, I'm Jim Shank.